Good morning, students. In our last lecture, I already taught you tenses. Let us first recapitulate, then we will move further for past tense and future tense. In last lecture, we have seen the introduction or definition, kinds of tenses and its definition, classification with that rules. Once again, let us recapitulate. Tense is the time, it denotes time and action. Time means the duration of work and action is the work done. Then we had seen three tenses, present tense, past tense and future tense. Present tense, what is going on currently. Past tense, already started and finished in the past. And future, will appear in future. Next is, we had seen that this three tenses are further divided into four forms. That is simple, also known as indefinite. Continuous, also known as progressive. Perfect, and perfect continuous. Then we had seen that present indefinite tense. This tense expresses habitual action, routine action and universal truth. Let us revise once again the structure of simple present tense in affirmative sentence. Subject plus V1 plus S, ES plus object. Negative, subject plus does not, do not plus V1 plus object. Do, does plus subject plus V1 plus object is your interrogative. Next is present continuous tense, the work which is going on continuously. Subject plus SMR plus V1 plus ING plus object. In negative, subject plus SMR plus not plus V1 plus ING plus object. Now, interrogative, SMR plus subject plus V1 plus ING plus object plus question mark also. In present perfect tense, subject plus has a plus verb 3 plus object. In negative, subject plus has not, have not, plus V3 plus object. And interrogative, subject has have plus subject plus verb 3 plus object plus question mark. Now, present perfect continuous. Affirmative sentence, subject plus has have plus been plus V1 plus ING plus since, for, plus the rest of remaining sentence. In negative, subject plus has have plus not plus been plus V1 plus ING plus for since plus the remaining sentence. Interrogative, has have plus subject plus been plus V1 plus ING plus since for plus the remaining sentence. Now, this is the recapitulation of last lecture, okay?